all the reaction and, of course, analysis coming. 1-1 at Stamford Bridge. I just wonder, after the turbulent time United have had, what that will do, Premier League-wise, just to the whole group, to get a result like that.
Yeah, it should give them a bit of confidence. You know, going to a Chelsea team that have been playing really well, especially coming away with a point, is, you know, it can only be positive, really. They've got a few fixtures now where they're very winnable as well. I think looking at the next 8, 9, 10 fixtures, well, you say they're winnable, you hope they're winnable. With the squad they've got, the players they've got, a new coach coming in to, you know, just to refresh them a little bit, revitalise them a little bit. Going to places like Chelsea and getting a point is a positive result.
But if I said to you at the start of the week, after all that had gone on, away game in the Champions League to win the group and go through and then get a point at the leaders, everyone would have taken that, wouldn't they?
Yeah, of course you would. You'd definitely take it. As I say, a turbulent week, losing the manager isn't great. And Michael's done well, hasn't he? It's not been vintage football, I'd say, but it's been football that's got us two good results that, say, you need to get a little bit of confidence. The team has been a mess the last 5 or 6 weeks, really not knowing which way they're going to play, no real structure about them. Now they need to settle down into some kind of system. Maybe today he's found a way of playing. I don't know what the new manager will do. So they need to go on from this. Now, going to Chelsea is a tough place to go, so they need to crack on and really kick on them.
Yeah, I think it's horses for courses. You know, that result there, that performance against Chelsea, a very, very hard side to play against at the moment. The players wouldn't have enjoyed that. There's no way the players would have enjoyed playing that way, but they'd enjoy getting the point, putting their foot in, working it hard defensively. They can't play that way against the next, as you say, next 10 fixtures. They'll play different. They'll play a bit more open, they'll play better, and they'll try and enjoy the game a bit more. But I know Manchester United players will be down going back home on that coach saying, well, if we play like that every week, it ain't going to be enjoyable. But it was right for the one-off game that was needed today and after the great result they got in the week. But there is so much more they need to do if they're going to really get themselves back where they need to be. And that will happen in time with a new manager.
That's really interesting. And not for a one-off game, but over a period of time, do managers worry about whether the players are enjoying it and responding to it?
No, they'll enjoy winning. Everyone enjoys winning, but I think players will play better and you'll get more wins if they love what they're doing. Every now and again, games like that, under these circumstances, where their club is at the moment, that is the right performance for today. When they pick the side, Ronaldo out before the game, I'm looking at it from a manager's point of view, thinking, OK, that solidness in midfield is where Chelsea's strengths are. They've got the two little inside forwards, the two deep midfield players. That's their strength. And he's tried to smother that. And he did that today. But you can't expect Man United to go and play like that week in and week out against Crystal Palace, whoever they're playing. They're going to take the game to them. And that's where the club's got to go forward. And that's where United fans wouldn't stand for that every week. They really wouldn't.
I think when I look back at our team, it's probably a little bit of a myth that you think game, gung-ho, trying to score goals, trying to win games by playing brilliant football. Sometimes you have to have performances like that. You have to respect who you were playing against. And there's many...
But the difference was you had an identity at the time of the way you would play.
Well, we changed, Steve. You think of Man United, you probably think 4-4-2, going for it, wide players. Sometimes you go to Chelsea, you go to Barcelona, you go to Liverpool, the best teams, 4-5-1. Yeah. And you stay in the game. It's not always the best. You probably show more quality than they have done today. But sometimes it's just a scruffy win. Go away, respect the opposition, sit behind the ball. You might just get one chance, two chances, but you've got to take them.
And what about Glenn's point about players? Did you used to enjoy that then?
It was the way we had to win sometimes. Now, look, if you come away from win, great.
My point is you can't put a team out, and Man United team, with the talent that's in that squad, you can't put a team out like that every week to play that way and try and win and get up the league and win a league. That's what my point. Today was, for me, Michael's got it absolutely spot on. Whoever picked the team has got it absolutely spot on for today's performance against Chelsea in the form that they're in. Paul, you're correct. They're a great side at the moment, in a great run. They couldn't come here today and be expansive. But for going forward, I know Manchester United fans are not going to stand for playing that way, because there's going to be games when they play that way and they're going to lose. So it's a stepping stone, but it's not the template for United to go forward.
Where do you stand on all this?
I'm always balancing it, and I totally get what the lads are saying. I'm just thinking, for the future, sometimes I think you've got to have less of a short-term... OK, the best chance they had of getting points today was doing what they did. So yeah. I sit here and agree with
but
that.
But moving forward now.
But I just wonder what, you know, if your end game is to be up there with Manchester City, Liverpool, play the way they do, you know, which they don't really change for many teams at the moment. You look at Liverpool, they don't change when they go away. If you want to get to that level, that's my next question to the lads. Well, is this short-term thinking then just going to try to grab a point, which is fine, which is good, they've grabbed the point, so, you know, I'm sat here sort of... But they're better, they've got to want more than that in the future.
Are they better than that, Michael?
How do they get better than what they are at the minute?
Well, I think it has to be coaching.
You can't be playing like that, can it?
You think in the midfield area, can that team compete with Manchester City? Can it compete with Liverpool, keeping the ball the way they do? The quality's not there, Michael.
No, and I don't disagree that the quality's not there, but what I'm saying is, if that's Burnley, if that's Brighton, if that's a lot of teams in this league, I get why you would chop and change and think, right, we're playing Norwich at home this week, we're going to play a bit more. Now we're going to Man City, let's short. But I just think if you're trying to get to that top level, like Manchester United are, I can't then accept that you're going to keep going to half the teams in the league away from home or against the good teams at home and keep and play like that team. Because you're never going to get better.
They won't play like that. It's only against the best teams they're going to play. They get forced to play like that.
But how do they improve if they keep...
Well, that's got to be down to a coach. If you've got the same squad of players, and we're saying this squad of players potentially are as good as Chelsea's, it then has to be down to the coach.
To play that system and play that team was the best they could do today. And if Chelsea had a couple of shots from distance and they didn't create any chances, and then you go, well, that's working. But it wasn't like that. We could be sitting here quite easily. De Gea's made a great save with his foot. He's tapped one on the bar. Rudiger at the end there. If United have lost that game, we're sitting here going, my word, they can't play like that.
And they've learned nothing.
Exactly. So what I'm saying, they've got the point, which they needed. The point was more important than the performance or the way they played. They needed a point at Chelsea. Now they've got a good run of fixtures where I think they're going to go, right, there's a platform now to go and let's improve it, whoever the manager is. But at this moment in time, they were very, very close. I mean, the first goal doesn't happen normally. That's a schoolboy error from Jorginho. They break away and they get themselves 1-0 up. You know, half-time, there's no way they'd have been sitting there thinking we're going to go 1-0 up in this game the way we're playing. They'd only had two touches in Chelsea's box in the first half. And those touches are not possessions. They're probably a flick off somebody's toe. That was their performance up until half-time. They're now 1-0 up. They get the result, but they cannot play that way and expect to actually progress back to the United where they want to be. And it's going to take time, but it's. I don't think United fans will stand for that against lesser teams.
They won't. No, there's no way they will. And that's my point is that's the way. With this squad of players, that's the way they have to get points against the big teams. Mm. It's the only way they could do it. They can't go toe-to-toe with them. Now, they'll go next week and they'll play
games. Well, Thursday night is Arsenal, for instance.
Yeah.
So what would you do differently on Thursday to what we saw today?
We'd play centre-forward for a start. I think Cristiano will play. I think the two wide players will still probably play. Possibly play two of the midfield players instead of three of them. So Fernandes comes in as well, instead of Matic or Fred. And they've been more attacking. But Arsenal are nowhere near the quality of Chelsea. They're nowhere near the quality of Liverpool. They're nowhere near the quality of Manchester City. I think that's a terrible result today for Chelsea. Shocking result for them at home, going for the league against a United team who have been battered, really battered the last 4 or 5 weeks. I think it's a terrible result for Chelsea.
Time. It hasn't been a recognisable Manchester United plan. Has it surprised you in any way, the way they've approached this?
No, not at all. I don't think it's surprised us, but... It's even though all the stats, everything looks as if it's favouring Chelsea, actually Manchester United are in a decent enough position here. They've kept a clean sheet. It's exactly what they wanted to do to grow into the game. And they haven't been, you know, the Manchester United team that we expect, that we've seen of old. But this is the way he wanted to play. And actually, he's probably played it in a decent way. And now in the second half, you would fancy them to actually start not coming out, but, you know, they've got options, let's say, and they wanted to stay in this game. And they've got what they wanted so far.
And they've limited Chelsea to two chances in that first half, Glenn.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Chelsea have got to up their game as well. But, you know, for me, United have played with the handbrake on. They really have. But they've got in. This is where they've got away with it. You know, Hudson-Odoi, I think, has got to really whip that higher. If he lifts that and puts a bit of whip on it, you can't not take them chances at this level. Poor defending from Lindelof. And De Gea just puts his foot out. Werner's looking for it. Mm. He's saying, can you pass to me? No. Hudson-Odoi's done the right thing, but just sticks his left ankle out and gets a touch. But that is probably the best chance of the whole game.
Werner is waving his arms. He's not on. No. I just think, just literally lift a foot. I don't even think you have to go that high just to go over De Gea's foot. Talking to De Gea, he gets a touch on this, goes he, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. Just a faint one, but I think it was probably enough. I think that could have been dipping in, actually. I think Chelsea have been brilliant in this game, apart from that final bit, that last bit of finishing. In and around the box, they haven't been great. Everywhere else, I think they've been really good.
What about Manchester United's approach, particularly when they get in the Chelsea half? Quite narrow, you saw right at the start.
That was right at the start, yeah. It was like almost a different way of playing, really wanting to press high straight away. But this lasted about 5 minutes, Steve. They couldn't really keep this going. As we see, this is probably the first 5 minutes. I think Sancho, he's got to stop that ball going to the fullback. He approaches the centre-half all wrong and they're out. But, yeah, it's, you've got to be fit to play that way. You can't just bring it on all of a sudden from 2 days working with Michael Carrick since the Villarreal game. Totally different from the way they played over there. You need work at this. And if the new manager has had this influence, this could take 4 or 5 weeks to get anywhere near up to it. And you know, I think Chelsea at times, some of the football they've played has been really good. It's just that final bit, the missing. But United, they're still in the game, as Michael said, at 0-0, you're always in the game.
You're seeing Chelsea putting some lovely moves together because, quite frankly, United are not pressing correctly together. But at the end of the day, there's a punt in the end. Look what happens. The ball drops down. It's a poor header from Matic. And again, there's the spare players. Chelsea, when they pick their heads up, they've got two spare players to play to. And Ziyech there trying to chip the keeper, sort of a semi-shot come cross. But, you know, there's spare players on the pitch for Chelsea everywhere. And Hudson-Odoi here really has got to be alive. There's a little overlap. It's a great ball. What a ball that is. You know, and Hudson-Odoi suddenly becomes the wing-back for a split second. He's got to arrive round the back there, and they're in for a goal. But United have got to improve with the ball.
Would your concern be if Chelsea get the first goal here, what United can then do?
Well, that was my concern right at the outset. When you're playing a really defensive team like Manchester United are, the last thing you want to do is concede early because you've really got no options. Then you're just trying to stay in the game until later on when you can change things a little bit. So they, as much as they haven't been brilliant, Michael Carrick will absolutely be delighted with where he's at half-time now. Now he's thinking, right, go on, go and do that again for the next 10, 15 minutes. And then we might start thinking about going and win the game. I think to start with, he wanted to stay in it. His mind might start changing the longer the second half goes.